Hey, TJ Schwarz here, designer of the CRKT Parascale. In this video, I'm going to show you how to swap out the cord on your knife. You could do this if your cord is old, dirty, and damaged, or if you just want to change the color or try to find a new and unique way to wrap the knife. Now, this is actually a single strand of paracord. It begins at the front of the knife and ends at the back. It doesn't have the center core strands, so it's just actually the sheath of 550 paracord. That way it lays flat and is able to double back on itself like this. As you can see, it makes that V pattern, doubling back on itself to prevent itself from crossing the path of the blade, which is what allows this to be done on a folder. Real quickly, I'm going to show you what you're going to need to be able to do this. You'll need a lighter, some 550 paracord of your choosing or something similar, another knife or pair of scissors. Another thing that's handy is something made out of metal that you're not worried about getting any residue from melted paracord on. It can be handy to have this when you go to melt the end and you want to flatten it or round it out. Now, obviously, the first thing to do is to remove the existing cord. The pocket clip can stay on during this operation. It can stay on through the whole process. It can be easier if you take it off, but for me, I just leave it on. As you can see, it begins with this knot here. If it's melted or receded or too tight to be able to remove it, what you can do is cut it anywhere along the path, and then you can unravel it from there. I'm just going to untie this knot. Now that I have this untied here, I'm going to show you something that I highly recommend for your safety. Taking that blue painter's tape I mentioned earlier and folding it over the actual edge of the blade can keep you from cutting yourself, because you'll have to have the blade open while you're doing this. With this knot undone, you'll be able to start unraveling the cord. As you can see, the tail end of this cord just goes in through a hole at the top of the handle and exits there. So when you start pulling on it, it should pull right through. Now it'll get to where you'll be able to understand exactly how this works. You can see how it's just a little hole in the handle and the cord has gone through it, and pulling on it removes it. So this is where the clip might be in the way, but you can just pull it out from under the clip and on through the knife. As you can see, it'll just keep doing that all the way to the front. Okay, you can see how we've unwrapped this knife all the way to the front. On the very last wrap, it enters the handle in a small hole there. What's going on is on the other end of that cord, it's been melted and knotted into a little ball so that it won't pull through the hole. So you'll have to just push on the cord until it starts to reveal itself in there. And then you'll just have to fish that end and pull it through. As you can see, I've got the cord started through there. You can see the end of the cord there, how it's been melted. That's what prevents it from pulling through. And now, by pulling on this cord, you can actually remove it from the handle. Now, this is where a cool feature of this knife really shines. With the cord removed, this is a fully functioning knife. Nothing has changed about the mechanism. Nothing has changed really about the ergonomics. The advantage of this is for anyone out there who's interested in modding knives. If you've ever modded a knife in the past, that is, modified a knife that has normal scales and you're taking it apart and changing things, doing different finishes and whatnot, it's pretty easy to mess something up on your knife, whether you're assembling and disassembling it and losing parts or something like that. With this knife, you can change the color, you can do all this, and you can be sure that you're never going to ruin the knife. As you can see, it's fully functional. And with that in mind, if you were out in the wilderness and you needed that cord and you wanted to take it off but you didn't want to lose the functionality of your knife, you can go right ahead and do that. Okay, now that we've got the old cord removed, it's time to get the new cord prepped. What you're going to want to do is stretch this out, figure out the exact length. It's roughly 4 feet, and cut off a section of your new cord that's substantially longer. I'd have quite a bit extra. Even like an arm span length, 5-6 feet would be awesome. After you have that section cut, you're going to see that there's some white cords on the interior of this sheath here. You're going to want to grab those and pull them out. As you can see, it's just a free-floating sheath over those cords. The sheath is all we need. Once you're down to just the sheath, you want to really establish this flat profile by pinching this cord, starting at one end and working your way to the other end, just dragging it through. You can establish a real flat pattern to it. This helps keeping it from getting twisted and whatnot as you're kind of wrapping the knife, if it's already a little bit of a ribbon shape to begin with. Next, using our metal surface and a lighter, we're going to burn the ends and change their shape. So on one end, we're looking for a blob, not a huge blob, just enough to grab. By looking at that hole from the interior on that handle, you can tell exactly what size it needs to be. You need to make sure it's also shallow and flattened enough that it's not protruding up into the blade path. That's what I like to use this for, so you can kind of dab it and flatten the end. The other end, I find it helps turn into as much of a needle as you can, just kind of melting it and stretching it out a little bit. That's not as necessary, but it does help. All right, guys, here's what I've come up with. It's not pretty and it doesn't have to be. Just got a bit of a blob on this side. If you look from a cross section, it would be kind of T-shaped because you don't want it to be able to pull through that slot. This is stretched out into a little bit of a needle shape. Like I said, doesn't have to be pretty. So now for the part that's kind of fun, really. So obviously you're going to want to start this from the inside. So reaching in through this hole, as you can see, it just pops right through. That's how you want to start it. Now make sure with this ribbon profile that you're just keeping it flat the whole time you do this. Now I've got the cord pulled all the way tight. You just want to double check in here that it's not protruding. If it is, you'll just want to melt it again and flatten it out. It can take a little experimenting, but it's generally pretty easy to get that. So you're going to start wrapping over the top of the knife, just like that. Like I said, if you can keep that ribbon shape when you're pulling it over, that's really helpful. And then here, you're just going to want to find the end of your cord. This is where having too long of a cord can kind of come back to bite you. But like I said, you definitely want to have enough to reach the end. And making sure that you didn't twist that ribbon or start on an opposite side or do anything like that. You start it through there. As you can see, that's pretty easy. And then you're just going to want to slowly pull it through, making sure that the ribbon doesn't get all twisted up. Looks like I did get a little bit of a twist in there. Okay. So as you can see, flat all the way over. That's how you want to start it. Pull it tight, go over again right next to it. And then you just repeat. It's going to go into that hole back and forth. One of the things I'll definitely tell you to keep in mind is keep this really, really tight, extremely tight right now, and even more tight than you want it to be when it's done, because I'll show you why. Now I'm far enough back to where I'm under this pocket clip again. As you can see, it's not a big problem. You just got to feed it under there and go through. Okay, just a minute or two later, I've made the very last pass through the very last little loop there, and I pull it back over, and as you can see, that hole is wide open, so you just want to feed it in. And it'll come out the back there. Again, making sure to keep this from twisting or anything. And it reveals there. So now I'm about to tell you why it's so important to keep this as tight as it is. So as you may have experienced working on projects in the past, it can be hard to tie a knot super, super flush in situations like this. So the benefit of having that cord so tight is you can tie a knot, and if you can push it down as best you can, as low as you can, right there. And then what I would recommend is cutting and burning it while it's still kind of revealed like that. I'll go ahead and do that. As you can see, with the knot kind of protruding, it's easier to burn it without melting the handle or risking any damage to the knife. So go ahead and do that. And then because this cord is so tight, it can actually relax a little bit. And what it'll do is it'll suck that knot down into that void. So if you kind of massage this cord, it draws itself back up onto the handle. And it does the job of making sure that that knot is really down tight in that pocket. As you can see, it can actually be totally flush. Now, as you can see, this is the same knife. Totally different look with just a couple dollar modification. This 550 paracord's really easy to find. I think they make just about every color under the sun. Feel free to customize and do whatever you like. Thanks for watching, guys.